260 students took the next step towards becoming doctors this morning. Drexel University's College of Medicine welcomed the class of 2018 with a traditional white coat ceremony. Proud family and friends looked on as the incoming class donned their white coats for the first time. The students also recited the Hippocratic Oath, signifying their passage into the medical community.
Breast cancer research gets a big boost from Pennsylvania tax refunds.
The money will go toward finding new and better treatments. The Pennsylvania Breast Cancer Coalition today presented a check for $100,000 to researchers at Drexel University College of Medicine. They are working on new targets for advanced breast cancer to eventually develop drugs that can contain and kill cancer cells.
Our faculty has developed a new understanding of how pre-malignant cells convert to invasive breast cancer cells. Their groundbreaking research may lead to a day when we can say breast cancer used to take lives.
This is the lab where the work is being done at Drexel. The new research money comes from the Refunds for Research campaign that allows Pennsylvania taxpayers to donate their state tax refunds.
Two Drexel University researchers have received $100,000 in grants to study breast cancer. Doctors Alessandro Fattatis and Mauricio Reginato received them from the Pennsylvania Breast Cancer Coalition. It's part of the Refunds for Research campaign in which taxpayers can donate their state tax refunds to science. Dr. Fattatis is focused on cancer development, while Dr. Reginato is testing new drugs for triple-negative breast cancer.
I want to talk about the treatment of the people involved in this now. Dr. Nita Gupta is the medical director of the Division of Pain Medicine and Regional Anesthesiology at Hahnemann University Hospital and Drexel University College of Medicine. And Danielle Thor is the director of Temple University EMS. And Sarah Paranick is the associate director of Temple University EMS. I appreciate all of you joining us this evening. Dr. Gupta, to you first.
Yes.
As you're looking at the types of injuries that doctors are seeing here, what does that tell you about what happened inside of the train?
Well, you can imagine with the magnitude of a collision such as this that there's going to be tremendous injury, head injuries, rib fractures, orthopedic fractures, and what we have heard at many of the local hospitals that these are the injuries that people have had. This is what physicians train for. As an anesthesiologist, this is what emergency personnel are ready to do, first responders are ready to do to take care of individuals with these kind of injuries.
It was an all-out effort here. When you think of Dr. Gupta, what went on here, seven people lost their lives.
Yeah.
Here. It is, it's amazing
incredible.
That many people survive.
We are very fortunate in Philadelphia that we have a multitude of trauma centers. So locally, where this crash happened, Temple University, Hahnemann University Hospital, level one trauma centers were ready to go. Emergency response was there. We're very fortunate there wasn't much more injuries.
Well, we thank you all for joining us. And I mean, we appreciate people like you jump in and you run into danger.
Inside the trauma ward at Hahnemann University Hospital, doctors telling me the severity of the injuries revealed just how far and how fast these passengers were thrown.
The moment you saw these injuries, you thought this is consistent with a train derailment because they were thrown.
Absolutely. They had some broken bones, they had some bruising, they had some cuts and scrapes. Mostly everybody was what we call blunt trauma.
Stronger antibiotics have been the traditional answer to C. diff infections. But Dr. Neil Nandy at Drexel College of Medicine says they're becoming less effective.
About 10 years ago, something happened to the C. diff bug. A mutation existed that allowed it to secrete more toxin.
Eleanor took nearly a dozen rounds of antibiotics with no success. So to stop C. diff, Dr. Nandy uses a technique first documented in Chinese medicine 4,000 years ago. In a procedure similar to a colonoscopy, a small amount of gut bacteria from a healthy donor was transplanted to Eleanor.
The whole procedure itself takes no more than about 20 minutes.
It grows quickly and crowds out the C. diff bacteria, restoring a healthy balance.
The day after the transplant, I was perfectly normal and have been normal ever since.
90% cure for C. difficile with one transplant.
Well, there were smiles and hugs all around today at Drexel University College of Medicine in East Falls. That's because it's match day for the fourth year medical students. More than 250 students simultaneously open their envelopes to learn where they will spend the next few years. The letters are from institutions inviting medical students to join residency programs.